While you were busy taking down that fort, I happened to stumble upon the treasury.
You don't say.
It was the damnedest thing. in any case, amongst other things, I found maps and charts detailing various French trade routes.
What are you thinking, guest?
I thought perhaps we could use them to help the Royal Navy and fill our pockets. I stored these maps in your cabin, Captain, should you wish to use them. And congratulate you, Shane. He has returned to New York. But you look troubled.
Do you ever wonder if you're doing the right thing, yes? If you chose the right path?
I used to, my young friend, but not anymore. Not since I met the Colonel. And what's the question? The French are entrenched in our territory. It's about time we root them out.
Of course. You're right, Gist. Let's head back to New York.
Hi, Captain.
Oh, you New York girls, can she dance the polka? To Tiffany's I took her. I did not mind expense. I bought her two gold earrings, and they cost me 15 cents. And it's all
short and safe! Get off the swan!
I'm waiting for your instructions, sir.
We're ready and willing to do so.
Thank you. Manquez plus que ça.
crois que je peux l'atteindre. Je l'ai envisé.
Ugh. montre-moi où je suis.
Straight to land, Captain!
Blue's up! These are sticks! Get the maids free! Reef the topsails and gallants! Hold them in! Get off the wind!
I'm waiting for your instructions, sir.
Wie spät kann ich sehen?
Je crois qu'on peut l'emporter. Je le sens au plus profond. C'est ça? Ou bien le cuistot a voulu m'entraîner pour avoir touché à ses armes?
This is more like it.
You certainly look like a predator.
Arrête de gueuler, Landry. Fais ta patrouille, on en reparlera demain. Ça marche. Va rejoindre Tremblay. Réveille-le s'il dort encore. Lefèvre, Marcelin est en train de dégueuler sa vie. Je te colle sa patrouille. je te l'avertis.
Arrête-toi.
Qu'est-ce que vous avez bu sans en faire profiter les autres?
Je ferai tout ce que vous voudrez. Ne
me tirez pas.
Toi, halte.
Je vous en prie, ne tirez pas.
Tes dernières paroles.
Tu n'échapperas pas à ton sort.
Good catch.
Now that the undesirable element's out, it's our duty.
Now the business is right.
You'll not find better value.
What you have learned from Le Chasseur was confirmed. The local lawbreakers are changing tactics.
What's their plan now?
Their boss has hired Benjamin Franklin to produce new weapons for them. He's very well guarded.
Benjamin Franklin? The scientist?
You have heard of him. Good. He is making equipment to spread gases among the populace. Toxic ones, as it turns out.
The populace? I thought they would use it against the authorities. though that would be terrible as well.
The ruffians we have arrested refer to an intimidating woman. I believe she is behind these nefarious plans.
I look into this.
Thank you.
Hope. I pray it's not you.
Stepped outside in day.
What Franklin working on?
Not sure, but it sounds
Huh? No one interrupts this one. Really?
It is good to see you again. Your friend Hope said you were away.
I was. Sir, I've come to collect the results of your experiments.
Oh, well, it's a very good thing then. I just finished fixing the prototype. Here you go. I was preparing to leave for Philadelphia and then Europe. I was invited to lecture in London. Oh, would you be so kind as to inform Mistress Hope?
Of course. God, Hope. What are you doing with these felons? Turning the city against itself. What have you become?
Something the matter, Master Cormac?
No. Yes, just old memories.
When I am issued new recruits burdened with regrets, I tell them the surest way to lose them is with gunpowder.
You're right, Colonel.
This prototype seems very powerful. Use it with care, Mr. Cormac. Our intelligence says this thing can destroy certain fortifications, as well as injure several enemies at once. There is also a more subtle way to use it. Some of these grenades contain a strong sedative. Fire one into the crowd and they will fall asleep immediately. We should test this new weapon. Use it against that door. Use these grenades to destroy that door. Good work. Good work. I think you are ready to turn this new weapon against the ruffians who would have used it. There is an abandoned factory nearby hiding a dangerous poison. Right now, it only causes sleep. But I fear those outlaws are distinct. A more powerful formula could sicken, or perhaps even kill most of New York.
And that's my first target.
Be careful. Master Cormac, we understand that the ingredients are highly unstable.
All the better.
Really?
I mess with this, maybe I can lift the whole scripture.
This is dangerous! This is dangerous! Dangerous!
Of him. We have to find him again.
Must get out, or I'm as good as dead.
Let him think he's losing us. We'll surprise him soon enough. Keep running! Resistance is not the
best interest!
We have to find him again!
What marvelous destruction, Captain. I saw the smoke all the way from the Morrigan.
That should discourage those miscreants. New York is safe for now.
With all due respect, Colonel, it's going to take more than a few explosions to get rid of this kind of trouble.
The boy is right, Colonel Monroe.
Shay, was it? Congratulations. You just burned a whole lot of rats out of New York. I'm Jack Weeks. This is William Johnson. I don't know about him, but I'm pleased to meet you.
Pleased to meet you as well.
It is terribly dusty here. I'm sure Shay can recount his adventures to us over a pint. Hey, the first round's on the Colonel, huh?
Something the matter, Master Cormac?
Just a little confused. I must have breathed some of that gas.
Some ale will do you good. Come, we are all friends here. You will be taken care of.
From the Colonel.
Dear Master Cormac, my apologies for the brevity of this missive, but it is time we were honest with one another. You have demonstrated your loyalty and resourcefulness to the Templar cause, and this despite and perhaps because of your assassin origins. The manuscript the assassin sought has been in my possession for some time. I reclaimed it when my men found you marooned. The Grandmaster himself charged me to discover its meaning, a task I regret I have failed to complete. I leave it in your charge, Master Cormac. There is no one else I trust more. Now I leave for Fort William Henry, an ill-prepared garrison surrounded by hostile natives and the French army. We have requested reinforcements, but I doubt they will be forthcoming. I have no illusions that our resistance will be successful. I commit my life to the British Army, and my soul to the Father of Understanding. Yours, Colonel George Monroe.